Welcome to the Nerdified channel, where you can become a tech expert. This is an in-depth, step-by-step Zoom whiteboard tutorial that will cover everything. Let's start. After using Zoom for almost this entire year, I found that the whiteboard is the most useful feature as it helps explain things quickly and easily. So in this video, I will show you exactly how you can use a Zoom whiteboard feature to simplify difficult topics and make lectures less boring for your students, trainees, colleagues, or even board members if you work in an organization. At the end of the video, that is after almost 10 to 12 minutes, I'm also going to share a bonus tip, that is, how two simple Zoom whiteboard settings can prevent mischievous colleagues or even spoiled students from using the whiteboard when you are presenting. Also, I'm going to share a link to download a PDF copy of this entire whiteboard tutorial for later reference. Zoom whiteboard is available on all plans, even the free basic plan. To start using the Zoom whiteboard feature, you need to be in a meeting first. So, I'm in a class meeting and I want to explain mimicry in animals. Yes, that's the topic for this class. First step, once in a Zoom meeting, is to click Share Screen. Then click Whiteboard, Share. Here we go. This is our whiteboard. This bar on the top is the annotation menu with various tools available at your disposal. The mouse button is what you will click to get back to your mouse, your computer mouse or cursor, after you click on any of the other tools in this annotation menu. Then we have the text tool to type text. While in the text tool, you can click the format button to format your text. You can change color, make it bold, and even change the font size. If you want to edit the text you've already typed, click the select button, select the text that you want to edit, and then you can edit it. Next, we have the draw tool. You can draw shapes, transparent shapes, opaque shapes, lines, and arrows to explain the topic. You can highlight stuff using the transparent shape like this, so it's just like a highlighter. And yes, you can change the color and thickness of the shapes by clicking the format button. Want to edit the shape you've already drawn? Sorry, Zoom whiteboard won't let you do so. What you can do is use an eraser to erase the shape and redraw it. Or you can also move the shape using the select tool here. Then we have the stamp tool. You can quickly point out something using the arrows, checks, or crosses using the stamp tool. It is way faster to use the stamp tools for these specific shapes than the shapes tool. And of course, you cannot use the format tool to format shapes. They just come in one color. Over here, we have the spotlight button, which is just like a laser pointer used with real whiteboards and projectors. And we also have another way to point out things when collaborating with other participants or students. So say a student says, "I'm unable to understand that." That what? This, that. This what? Just point it out. Move the cursor to the top of the screen and click Enable Annotation for Others. The student on the other end will see a new tool appear on the screen. Then he or she can point it out using the arrow tool. The student's name will appear on the arrow like this. and you will know what that was, what this was that. Let me try again. And you will know what that was actually. Oh, whatever. Okay, then we have the eraser to erase stuff. Undo, redo to undo, redo actions. We also blessed with a clear button to clear all drawings, your drawings or viewers' drawings. I will click viewers' drawings. The arrow my student put up on the screen just disappeared. I can also save this whiteboard as a PDF or as an image to share with the class, colleagues or board members. Once done with the whiteboard session, click the X here to close the annotation bar and click Stop Share. Now, before I close this Zoom session, I have two important topics to share with you all. So, how do I insert an image in the whiteboard? I don't find a button here which says Insert Image or Paste Image. And what if I want to annotate while presenting a PowerPoint presentation? Can I do that? Well, the answer is there is no direct way to do so. What you can do though is, for example, if you want to work with an image, is to open the image or the website or the PowerPoint presentation first that you want to explain. Then move the cursor to the top and click New Share. Select the image you want to bring up, click Share, move the cursor on the top, annotate, and explain it. You can also explain a PowerPoint presentation this way. Make sure the PowerPoint presentation is open on the screen. Then you click New Share. Select the PowerPoint presentation that you want to explain with the annotation tool and then share. Alright, we are done. Let me explain the two settings that should prevent spoiled students and colleagues from ruining your whiteboard session in Zoom. You can change these settings while in the meeting too, but they will not move over to the next session. To implement this whiteboard related security setting for all the future meetings, go to zoom.us/profile/setting. Go to screen sharing, change who can share to host only. Under annotation, check only the user who is sharing can annotate. This should prevent others from sharing screen or annotating on your screen unless you permit them. To permit screen sharing in a particular meet, click Security and check Allow participants to share screen. And while in the whiteboard, which I'm just about to enter, and if you want others to write on the screen, move the cursor to the top of the screen and click Enable Annotation for Others. And once the student is done with the screen sharing part, you can go back to the top, to the menu, and click Disable Annotation for Others. So this is how you can temporarily give permission for others to annotate and later just take over the permission so that no one else tries to play with your whiteboard. That was it for this one. This is how to use whiteboard in a Zoom meeting to make learning interesting and less boring and less difficult and more fun. Do make sure you download the PDF version of this tutorial for quick future reference. Check out my other videos on using Zoom for teaching. I will put the link to the playlist in the description box below. If you like this video, hit the like button. share with your friends, and make sure to subscribe. And remember to comment if this video was outstanding, good, average, or horrible. I need your feedback. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.